It's time now to see what building components the project is made of. One of the major benefits of the BIM technology is that we can derive quantity takeoffs, schedules, and element lists at any time. Double-click on the door list in the Schedules, Elements section of the Navigator project map. Instantly, we see a list of all the door elements used in the building, according to type, size, and orientation. We can adjust the width of the last column and the height of the last row in the schedule by double-clicking on the right small handles in the ruler fields. The width of the column and the height of the row will change to the appropriate size. Click the Scheme Settings button to open the corresponding dialog. Display the Fields Door List panel. Open the Window Door folder in the list on the left. Add height and width values by selecting them in the list and then clicking the Add button below. Drag these before the 2D symbol item. Click OK. Notice that the door schedule has been automatically updated, and now the width and the height fields are also visible in the list. Select the double door with two side lights transom door in the schedule. Since we're working on a live editable BIM model, we can even modify certain elements from the interactive schedule lists. Change the height of the selected door element to 4,000 mm and the width to 5,200 mm. Use the icon in the upper panel of the schedule to select that particular door on the floor plan as well. The floor plan view is automatically displayed and the door is visible on the screen. The door is selected and the width and height are indeed changed. In this way, the interactive schedules are not merely lists of elements and their parameters, but real interactive model views, where all changes are reflected in the other views. In most cases, it makes more sense to make modifications in floor plan or section or 3D views. But in some cases, especially if the changes of some parameters are tied to other parameters, it's easier to find and change elements in a schedule view than trying to locate them on a floor plan. Return to the schedule by selecting its name from the window menu. Reset the original width and height values of the selected door by clicking the Undo icon twice. Let's see what else we can list. Click on the Scheme Settings button in the upper panel of the schedule. The Scheme Settings dialog appears. In the Schemes panel, we can select which schedule we would like to edit. Later, we'll create new schedules as well. Select the current door list. Display the criteria panel. Here we define the selection criteria by element type. Other criteria such as layer, story, 2D representation attributes, etc. can be added to narrow the selection to what we need. We want to deal with all the doors, so the element type criteria will do fine for us. Don't modify anything here. Let's open the Fields panel now. In the Fields panel, we define which information from the selected elements should be listed. There's a general set of attributes, such as layer, height, story, quantity, surface area, volume, etc., that can be associated with any element. Also, there's an element-specific, in our case door-specific, set of attributes such as orientation and thickness. Attributes that can be modified in the interactive schedule are shown in blue. Attributes which are already selected are grayed. By clicking on the arrow button beside the Add command and selecting the Add Object Parameters menu item, we can select any library part in the loaded libraries and then select any of their parameters to be available. Select the storefront door object in the ArchiCAD library. Select the material of the door handle and add it to the list of selected parameters. Information such as the cost or the manufacturer can also be added. Let's return to the Scheme Settings dialog by clicking on Cancel. We can add and remove schedule fields. Attributes can be added by simply dragging and dropping them from the available list among the schedule fields. Add ID from the general parameter set. Parameters can be moved up and down the field list by dragging them with the little arrows on the left. Move ID to the first field. Click OK. Returning to the door list, we can note some interesting changes. In the Schedule Options panel at the top left, tick in the Show Uniform Items as Single Entry option. This way, identical elements will be listed only once, but the Quantity field will still show the total number of those elements. We were unable to modify the Width and Height fields. The reason is that uniform doors have been merged. We are going to add dimensions to the preview picture in Schedule. Select the 2D symbol of the double door with two side lights transom door, then click on the Annotate button. The element preview opens in a separate window. We can use 2D tools to annotate, such as dimension, label, and text. Activate the dimension tool. Make sure that the linear dimension method is selected in the info box. Click on the points of the opening and the points of the door leaf. Double-click the last node, and then click with the hammer cursor to place the dimension line. Click OK in the Drawing Windows menu to close this window and apply the annotations to the selected 2D symbol field.